Welcome back, everybody. This is Charlie, SortofSurvival.com. On today's post, I'm going to show you another plant that you can use for survival needs if you had to. It's called the sotal plant, or better known as a desert spoon. Sometimes it gets confused with the yucca plant. I have one right here behind me I'm going to show you. Kind of looks like a yucca plant a little bit, but the stalk is different. And the leaves are also different. Okay, the leaves, if you can see here, hopefully it comes out on camera, they're flat and they got thorny spikes on the side. Okay. Now what you can use this plant for is these leaves here, once they're dethorned, can be used to make mats for sleeping on, or for making shelters out of, for walls and shade. The stalk can be used for spears, making atlatl handles out of them, for fire starting, for shelter building. The leaves also can be used to make baskets, to weave baskets out of, for cordage, and for making sandals. Now at the heart of this plant here is going to be kind of like of a tuber type portion that's used to make sotal, a drink called sotal, which is a kind of a alcoholic beverage. That once this heart of this is harvested, it's cooked and allowed to ferment. And also, it was roasted by early Indians for food. It was baked in the ground for a couple hours, and it was either eaten like an artichoke or pounded into a meal to make flour out of. And then the base of these leaves here have a spoon shape to them and can be used as spoons, which I'm going to attempt to retrieve the heart of this sotal plant here so I can show you it, and then also what the spoons look like, and then I'm going to harvest some of these leaves to make a mat out of and show you how that's done. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the camera and harvest this plant for teaching purposes, and then I'll come back. Okay, here's the progress I've made so far. What I did was I dug down underneath one side after removing some of the leaves so that I can get on the back side of it and kick it, and it breaks off real easy. Because down here underneath the plant, it's even kind of moist under here. What you need to do is work your way to the center by cutting all these dead ones off until you get to the center of all this. And then you'll have your portion that you need to harvest. So I'm going to keep working at this, and I'll be right back. Okay, this is Charlie. I'm back. I've actually got it cut down in half so I can show you the areas that they use. If you notice this area right here, it's a big chunk. Kind of look like a big old radish, but this is the heart of the plant there that's harvested after everything else is cut off. These shoots inside here are actually kind of soft, and they're easy to cut off once you get them all this big green stuff out of the way. But it's nice to have a hatchet or machete, or even a trenching tool like an army shovel that folds in half. That's what I use to cut this in half, because it goes a lot better along, or a lot better to cut with than a smaller type knife. But I gotta hand it to the Indians that that harvest these things, because they didn't really have all that great of tools to do it, and then other than probably digging sticks and very measly type of stone axes and stuff like that. But the part that they use for spoons You know, so the outside here, they're really kind of curved backwards, so they don't really look like spoon, but the closer you get to the center of here, I'm gonna show you by pulling one out, they become a little bit straighter. And if I dug the heart down a little bit further down here, I can actually cut through here and make a couple dozen spoons out of this one plant. Because here, the closer you get, like this right here, can be a bigger spoon. All they do is just carve it down to the shape they want and make the handle as long as they want, and they let it dry, and they can polish them up and use them for eating utensils. Yeah. So every part of this plant was used for something. So there you have the sotal plant, or the desert spoon, that you can harvest to get the heart of this right here, which takes a lot of work. It took me about 30 minutes to do this, but if you're in an area, and especially with a couple other people, and you're long-term surviving, or for some other reason, then you can use this to roast like a potato, or roast it and then grind it up into a meal and make flour, and make little fire cakes and stuff like that with it. So later on, I'm going to show you how to make mats out of the green leaf material on this. It's kind of time consuming, so I want to go ahead and save that for a later post. This is Charlie, SortofSurvival.com. Another method of gathering plants for your survival needs for food. Hopefully you learned from this segment. Stay prepared, stay alive, and see you back soon.